I'd like to call the order of the Public Improvement Commission hearing, March 2nd, 2017. The first item is a continued item of business on a petition by 6 West Broadway LLC for the granting of an earth retention license for the installation of a temporary earth support system within the following public ways in South Boston. This was new business on February 2nd, had its first public hearing on February 16th. The locations are West Broadway on its northeasterly side, southeast of Dorchester Ave, Dorchester Ave on its easterly side between West Broadway and West 2nd, West 2nd Street on its southerly side between Dorchester Ave and Athens Street, Athens Street on its southwesterly side, southeast of West 2nd Street. This is as shown on a set of plans entitled City of Boston Public Works Department, Engineering Division, Temporary Earth Retention Plan, 6 West Broadway, Dorchester Ave, West 2nd Street, Athens Street, South Boston, 3 sheets, dated January 2017. We will continue.
I spoke with them yesterday. They were interested in continuing. They knew they were supposed to show up. I don't know where they are.
Right. They've continued before, as this is how they got to here, but.
Okay, I don't think this has happened. Proper protocol on the situations of this nature. Can the commission, in their absence, continue?
Yes. No commission. So go on.
So the commission
entertain a motion to continue.
Entertain
a motion to continue.
I'll make a motion to continue item
to the
number
30th.
To March 30th.
I got to start again now? Okay, I'll make a motion to continue item number one on today's public hearing, continued agenda regarding West Broadway, Dorchester Ave, West 2nd Street, and Athens Street to March
30th,
2017.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
So moved. All right. The second item is on a petition by National Grid for the making of specific repairs within Commonwealth Avenue, Boston proper. Located on both sides, generally between Amory Street and University Road / Carlton Street, consisting of 4 new ventilation posts. This was new business on February 2nd, 2017. Had its first public hearing on February 16th, 2017. This is as shown on a set of plans entitled City of Boston Public Works Department, Engineering Division, Specific Repair Plans, National Grid, Commonwealth Avenue, Boston, 3 sheets dated March 1st, 2017. Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Jeff O'Donnell. I'm with CHA Consulting here on behalf of National Grid. Since our last meeting, it was requested that we revise the drawings to show the proper order and to revise the appearance of the vent posts as they will protrude through the sidewalks in the area. What National Grid has decided and is proposing here today is to use a rendition very similar to the vent posts that are used on their district regulator stations. It is a 4-inch steel pipe that will extend 4 feet above ground with a vent cap on top of it. So the 2-inch steel pipe will still be inside of the 4-inch steel, but the 4-inch steel will be what is seen to the public. There is a picture here on the drawing that is located on 185 Minot Street in Dorchester. This was approved a couple years ago by the commission when this regulator station was relocated from the intersection of Adams Street and Minot Street. So that's what we would propose. Other issues that were still open was the agreement, which I believe the city's legal department and National Grid's legal department have come to a satisfactory conclusion. I believe it was left for the city to sign it. And there was one final thing.
Grant allocation.
Yes, the grant allocation process.
Yep.
Tommy, can you follow up on that?
Yep. We've had one of our.
If you could identify yourself, please.
Yes. Tommy Fang, National Grid, from our gas project engineering department. So from the last meeting, we were asked to take the plans through the normal grant allocation process. We've had one of our personnel submit that through that process since the last meeting. Currently, it stands with the Boston Water and Sewer Commission. We're waiting for comments from them as to, you know, if they have any comments or when it's gonna move up to the next entity.
So at this point, we don't have the lines to these approved, so, and the agreement that we need from them needs to be executed by them and with our law department. So if bus, water, and sewer moves these pipes, then these would need to move. So until the pipes are approved, we shouldn't be voting on the location of the vent pipes.
Chong Liu, I'm the legal counsel for this board, and 2 weeks ago, three, 4 weeks ago, I started work on the legal agreement with National Grid's counsel. We agreed with all the terms, and but I haven't really received executed agreement from them yet. So I want to have that myself to look at it. Yeah, so.
Time to both go through the agreement and for.
I would hope so, because I already told them to go ahead to execute it. I understand this, you know, it may take some time for the paperwork to go through, but we'd rather have them.
We'll be all set with this for sure. In fact, that may be something where it's just stuck in a permit process. I've reviewed the plan. I have no problem with the plan, and it would be signed as it is. So that's not an issue for this, even this public hearing.
So we're just waiting on the agreement. Okay. All right.
It's our understanding that the three copies of that agreement are in the post, being delivered.
Okay. I would just ask also, you know, a steel pole, black pole with a cap on it, still not very, not inviting. You might want to look at some type of ornamental bollard, like that we've done elsewhere, you know, steel pipe. And it just doesn't look good.
So we chose this because it is something that has been approved?
Yeah, but you know, something, this is a little bit more of a, touristy area. University and stuff like that. You know, we want to expand upon that, I think. Okay.
In the interest of what's in the interest of what needs to happen, which is a good working relationship between amongst all of us, and Mr. Fang, hopefully you will recognize that just because we did something in one location may not fit all locations, and this is not a heavy lift. I think you may have enough time to find something that is demonstrative and suitable for the location. Because even the city has that same issue. When we install bollards, we don't install the same look throughout the city. We have variations to the theme, so it maintains your functionality as much as it meets the city's needs. So I think that there are some items that requires resolution, and it would be best that if you ask for a continuance of a suitable time, that you can get all your ducks in a row.
Okay. Yeah, we can look into an ornamental fixture rather than the normal cap.
And the legal agreements, and you can get it all squared away.
Yeah. If we have to, you know, call back the agreement and, you know, include a revised attachment, we can do that.
Given both the agreement and the design feedback, I'll entertain a motion to continue.
I'll make a motion to continue item number two. Petition by National Grid for making specific there is in Commonwealth Avenue to continue until March 16th.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
Yes, first public hearing item on a petition by the City of Boston Public Works Department for the making of specific repairs within Summer Street, South Boston, located between Melcher Street and West Service Road, consisting of curb realignment, sidewalk, roadway, and pedestrian ramp reconstruction, as well as new and relocated specialty pavement, street lights, street trees, street furniture, traffic signal infrastructure, and bicycle infrastructure. This was new business on February 16th, 2017. This is as shown on a set of plans entitled City of Boston Public Works Department Engineering Division Specific Repair Plans, Summer Street, South Boston, 5 sheets, dated March 1st, 2017.
Good morning. My name is William Eden. I am the Chief Civil Engineer for the City of Boston Public Works Department, and I'm here to present the reconstruction plans for Summer Street from 4th Point Channel to West Service Road. came before the Public Improvement Commission 2 weeks ago to present this project and review the plans. We are here today to seek approval of the plans and design, and we are moving forward to construction. We have not changed the plans at all since our last submission, and I just briefly want to go over the project. Summer Street, the work starts at Ford Point Channel and runs east towards South Boston for approximately 1,000 feet to the West Service Road. The project consists of flattening the sidewalks to make them ADA compliant, to include a separated bike lane, separated protected bike lane, and also we are including constructing three new crosswalks as part of the project. One crosswalk is at Melcher Street, and there are two mid-block crosswalks, one at the easterly end of the project and one at the midpoint. All three of these new crosswalks are going to be signalized for pedestrian crossing and safety. To talk about some of the public realm improvements for the project, I have with me Deneen Crosby from Crosby, Schlesinger, Smallridge. Deneen.
Thank you. Just to follow up on a couple of comments that we heard at the last hearing, one was to confirm that we had 6 foot clear for snow plowing.
Yep.
We do, we're set with that. We also had a meeting with the Commission for Persons with Disabilities, and they had a request that we remove one curb cut and make some very minor adjustments, and we've incorporated that into the plans as well. We did present the sidewalk treatments at the last meeting, but I'll run through them again. The street lighting is the Ford Point District fixture for the most part. That doesn't throw enough light to light the roadway, so they are interspersed with the larger Leotech fixture, which is the one that is proposed for in front of the convention center. So there'll be continuity of lighting down the street. So the pattern on the street is two Ford Point District fixtures, one taller fixture, and that's all been okayed by the street lighting department.
Any, yeah. The orientation of the Ford, the light fixture, is it parallel to the?
Parallel to the roadway. We will be planting street trees along the length of the street with clusters of them in the crossing locations. They meet the city standards of a minimum of 4x6 pit, and the detail is as per city standard. The cycle track is a bituminous concrete track, and we're infiltrating water with pervious pavement, pervious pavers.
I think we made a comment last meeting relative to the placement of some of these trees and looking at the planning as it relate to the pedestrian crossings, where they're right up as the oncoming traffic, the tree is right at the crosswalk and the visibility therein.
Yep.
Have we looked at that?
Yes. All clear. Yes.
All clear?
Yep.
Any, Ms. Crosby, to further punctuate the comment made by Mr. Hesford, the tree selection at the crosswalks at the very early stage should be such that through its growth and formative years, its formation should not obstruct sight distance.
Understood.
20 years later, when the trunk is like this, yes, one can imagine.
Yes.
So we have thought that through.
Okay.
Thank you.
And lastly, we do have seating along the street, and it is a steel bench. It's the bench that's being used now in Audubon Circle, and we both have benches with backs and backless ones.
Any questions or comments from the commission?
Well, yes.
No. And your Todd?
No.
Nope. That was the public. All right. I'll entertain a motion.
I'll make a motion to approve the petition by the City of Boston Public Works Department for making specific repairs in Summer Street in South Boston as described and read into the record by the chair. shown on the set of plans entitled City Boston Public Works Department Engineering Division, specific repairs plan for Summer Street in South Boston, 5 sheets dated March 1st, 2017.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
So moved. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Next, on a petition by John Hancock Life Insurance Company for the vertical discontinuance of portions of Stewart Street, Boston proper, located on its southerly side at address number 380, generally between Berkeley Street and Clarendon Street, vertically above the grade of the sidewalk. This was new business on February 16th, 2017. This is as shown on a plan entitled City of Boston Public Works Department Engineering Division Discontinuance Plan, vertical 380 Stewart Street, Boston proper, 1 sheet dated January 4th, 2017. Good morning.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. My name is Jeff Lewis. I'm with the firm Colliers International, representing John Hancock on this project. Thanks for having us here today. I'm joined here by Bruce Pearson from John Hancock, representing ownership, John Schmidt from Niche Engineering, Damian Siebert from Haley and Aldrich, our Geotech, and Chris Rainier from Goulston and Storrs. Best to give, we have three things all in sequence here. Before I turn it over to John, just kind of remind the commission, we're here for a discontinuance on the canopy, earth retention system, and groundwater recharge wells. We'll have to come back for specific repairs at a later date as we progress in the design, but we wanted to come here to get a level of comfort and continue, so we can continue on with our design on this.
Good morning, commissioners. The discontinuance to today's ask is for this canopy that begins at street grade, projects here 53 feet above grade, and projects back down almost like an eyebrow. At maximum height is 53 feet and 15 feet from the building face at that point. We discussed a little bit in new business about the impacts to accessible access along the lower portion there. And we have a conceptual design that I can present to you, and I also met with Sarah before this hearing with disabilities. So we are going to continue with pursuing that design in good faith. But the idea is, and I have handouts so you can be able to see them, but the idea is that we'll continue the raised 6-inch raised granite curb here with some uplighting to the point where the projection is 10 feet above grade. And this still maintains a 10-foot wide sidewalk access. So this is submitted to Sarah for her initial response, and as we proceed with the design and come back for specific repairs, we will ensure that everybody is happy with what we're proposing.
John, the uplighting, did you mention the words uplighting?
Yeah, this and conception now will be proposed uplighting there. That will be captured in specific repairs. This is what's before you today, so it's strictly discontinuous.
The actual fixture that's going to accommodate the uplighting, where is that fixture going to be on the sidewalk attached to your building?
That is to be determined, because right now it's conceptual. As the design progresses,
so
we will ensure.
Since you understand our limitations,
I anticipate it will be behind the building, powered by the building, and captured in the LMI at that time.
So you're looking at a 10-foot clear now, with that obstruction being put there, 10 feet,
yeah.
With the specific repairs, basically pre-plannings, parking meters, street lights. Does that limit even, if I take that down even further?
Right, that we'll have a 26-inch furniture zone, so that 10 feet will be 7.5 feet in that area.
So 7.5 feet total for a main city arterial street. Did you do an analysis on the LOS for pedestrians?
We will do that when we come back with specific repairs.
So since what Mr. Hispert's asking is tied to what you do in the discontinued area, I mean, this is where we are a little bit concerned, because once we discontinue the area,
if we cannot come, I understand what you're
hopefully saying. We will be good partners where you do not naturally assume that you can do whatever, that would be awkward, because then we will hold that part until you sort things out.
We are aware that the streetscape has to meet the city standards before we complete the design showing the compromising those air rights in that
on the city arterial sidewalk. Thousands of pedestrians, 10 feet would probably be a minimum.
Okay.
Right?
Thank you.
And that's 10 feet of the clear pedestrian.
Unobstructed clear pedestrian walkway.
Problem with from an aesthetic viewpoint, it's really nice, and we just want to make, I mean, it's good stuff. But just hope that one doesn't compromise the functionality of the sidewalk, which we need.
Understood.
Other questions or comments on the vertical discontinuance? And your top? I'll entertain a motion on the vertical discontinuance.
I'll make a motion to approve the petition by John Hancock, Life Insurance Company, for the vertical discontinuance of portions of Stewart Street, Boston proper, as read into the record by the chair and as shown on the plan entitled City of Boston Public Works Department, Engineering Division, Discontinuance Plan, Vertical 380 Stewart Street, Boston proper, one sheet dated January 4, 2017.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
The next item is on a petition by John Hancock Life Insurance Company for the making of specific repairs within Stewart Street, Boston proper, located on a southerly side at the address 380, generally between Berkeley Street and Clarendon Street, consisting of a new groundwater recharge infrastructure. This was new business on February 16th, 2017. This is as shown on a plan entitled City of Boston Public Works Department, Engineering Division, Recharge License Plan, 380 Stewart Street, Boston, one sheet, dated January 2017.
Good morning, John Smith, Ditch Engineering and the design team. We are proposing five injection wells within the sidewalk of Stewart Street, and this is necessary in order to comply with the zoning Article 32, Groundwater Conservation Overlay District. The building will have a storage tank within it, and at which point the water will then be pumped into the injection wells in the sidewalk. The wells are 8-inch diameter caps, and they're proposed within the furniture zone. We also initially explored putting injection wells in a recharge system in the alley behind the building, but after study of the area, the mounding was a concern about negative impacts to neighbors.
You're gonna what?
We're concerned about mounding and flooding neighbors, abutting basements, because there, in the last several years, there's been two systems installed in that alley already.
And then there's been problems, that you're telling me?
We don't want to cause problems, and we feel if we do this, we will create problems.
Yeah, we approve this.
Yeah. Other questions or comments? I'll entertain a motion on the specific repairs.
I'll make a motion to approve the petition by John Hancock Life Insurance Company for making specific repairs within Stewart Street, Boston proper, as described and read into the record by the chair and as shown on the plan entitled City Boston Public Works Department Engineering Division, a recharge license plan for 380 Stewart Street in Boston. The one sheet is dated January 2017.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
So moved. The next item is on a petition by the John Hancock Life Insurance Company for the granting of an earth retention license for the installation of a temporary earth support system within Stewart Street, Boston proper, located on its southerly side at the address 380, generally between Berkeley Street and Clarendon Street. This was new business on February 16th, 2017. This is as shown on a plan entitled City of Boston Public Works Department, Engineering Division, Temporary Earth Retention Plan, 380 Stewart Street, Boston, one sheet, dated November 4th, 2016.
Good morning, John Schmidt with Niche Engineering and with ownership in the design team. We're proposing a soldier pile lagging system along Seaport, along Stewart Street to allow for the construction of the story wall foundation for the three-story deep garage as part of the 380 Stewart Street project. Soldier pile lagging will project into the public way 4 to 5 feet, and they will be cut to be below 6 feet below grade after completion.
Yeah, we just received the construction manner plan as of yesterday, so we really haven't gotten into the crux of the methodology of the construction that relates to the earth retention system, but given the location where it is at the back of sidewalk, I think we can move forward with this vote. Upon a subsequent review of the CMP.
Amy, the 6 feet cutoff, is it 6 or 7 feet? I lost six. Thank you.
Other questions or comments? Mayor John, how is that? I'll entertain a motion.
Make a motion to approve the petition by John Hancock Life Insurance Company for the granting of earth retention license for the installation of a temporary earth support system within Stewart Street. All is read into the record by the chair and is shown on the plan entitled City of Boston Public Works Department Engineering Division Temporary Earth Retention Plan, 380 Stewart Street, Boston, one sheet dated November 4, 2016.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
So moved.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The next item is on a petition by Lendlease Clippership Wharf LLC for the making of specific repairs within the following public ways in East Boston, consisting of curb realignment, sidewalk and roadway reconstruction, as well as new and relocated specialty pavement, pedestrian ramps, streetlights, street trees, street furniture, landscaping, driveway curb cuts, and retaining walls. This was new business on February 16th, 2017. The streets are Lewis Street on its northwesterly side, southwest of Marginal Street, and Monsignor Albert A. Jacoby Road on both sides, southeast of Clippership Lane. This is as shown on a set of plans entitled City of Boston Public Works Department Engineering Division, Specific Repair Plans, Lewis Street, Monsignor Albert A. Jacoby Road, Clippership Wharf, East Boston, four sheets dated February 2017.
Good morning. My name is John Schmidt with Ditch Engineering. And to my right is
Eric Tinkhauser from Lendlease.
And Vita Schlafsky with Lendlease.
Clippership Wharf is currently in construction. They're doing site utility improvements, soil excavation, and foundation support. The overall project consists of four six-story buildings, 480 unit residential units, with a 300 space below grade garage. The facilities will include a fitness club, a restaurant, a cafe, docking facilities, and about 190,000 square feet of open space. The application before you today is for specific repairs on Lewis Street, as well as Monsignor Jacoby Road. On Lewis Street, the existing Lewis Street is about 70 feet, the right of way is 70 feet wide with a 20 foot wide sidewalk. We are proposing improving that sidewalk to provide complete street guideline requirements, minimum 8 foot wide concrete sidewalk. We are proposing bump outs with some street tree improvements and landscape improvements, and we are proposing a parking lane, as well as benches, bike racks, and new street lighting. At new business, Mr. Hesford raised concerns about site distances with the trees and the bump outs, and we consulted the city's Vision Zero policy, and also consulted ASHTO requirements, and I provided Mr. Hesford with a memo and drawing earlier this week. I hope that satisfies your concerns. And also, Mr. Hesford raised concerns about a proposed signage plan, and we had also forwarded that to you last week as well. So I hope that we're in good standing with your concerns.
It's under review right now.
So. Yeah. So with that, I'll just take questions.
Question that may not have direct bearings for this commission's vote. As part of your Chapter 91 license, did you have to provide any access to the waterfront area?
Yes.
Yeah. And so if I'm a citizen of East Boston or Hyde Park for that matter, and if I want to enjoy the waterfront, can you walk me through how I gain access into your property so that I, as a private citizen, don't have to deal with private property versus city property?
And this viewport, which helps us, this is Lewis Street right here. This is the harbor. So it's a harbor walk that runs along the water here, back into the site here over a footbridge, around here, this facility here. We're up here now, and coming down this here. So that's all open to the public.
And the maintenance of that harbor walk in front of your property is, let me say it differently, who is undertaking the maintenance of the harbor walk that goes in front of your property?
The ownership, Lendlease Development.
Thank you.
We've been through the Chapter 91 approval process and the Boston Conservation Commission approval process, and all those have been granted.
Thank you.
What's the schedule for when you're going to start the repairs or reconstruction of Lewis Street?
Probably the fall of this year. That's what fall. Yeah,
perfect.
Fall.
Just concerned about the tall ships event.
No. I wish we were that close, but no.
John,
I like your skin.
Because it is private property, we have no business looking into it. But the lighting within the walkway is to a uniform, consistent standard.
Within the harbor walk?
Harbor walk in front of this gentleman's property.
Yes.
Yeah. So it's adequately lighted.
Yes.
Yeah. I don't have the details on that, but.
Sir, if you could be mindful of providing, because legally we can't look into it.
Yes.
I don't think so. But as a private citizen, when one walks through, they don't understand the subtleties of it from a legal liability. So it is still incumbent upon you to provide adequate lighting.
Absolutely.
To meet the general expectations of someone who walks through.
Yes.
So maintenance of those lights, ensuring that there's adequate lighting, is all incumbent upon you, sir.
Correct.
Thank you.
And we fully understand that.
Other questions or comments?
Right, it's all done.
Great time. Members of the public.
Okay, and then the in Second Street, I'm sorry,
please.
It's both yep. On Lewis, is on Senior Colby Way, which is a very long name for a street that's only about 200 feet long. But it's a public way cul-de-sac here. We are reconstructing the sidewalk here. It's all new street trees. We're also adding a bump out and some plantings here.
Reconstruct the roadway in compliance with current design standards. Maybe that's a current street today, Ellis?
Yep.
It's a big one. Any questions or comments on this second? Given your comments, do you feel comfortable with a motion to proceed? Or?
Yes.
All right. I'll entertain a motion.
I'll make a motion to approve the petition by Lendlease Clippership Wharf LLC for making specific repairs on Lewis Street in Monsignor Albert A. Jacoby Road in East Boston, as described and read into the record by the chair. Shown on the set of plans entitled City of Boston Public Works Department Engineering Division, a specific repairs plan for Lewis Street in Monsignor Albert A. Jacoby Road, the Clippership Wharf in East Boston. There's four sheets and dated February 2017.
You hear a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
So moved.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The next item is on a petition by ENT LLC for the acceptance of a pedestrian easement adjacent to West 3rd Street, South Boston, located on the southwesterly side, generally between A Street and the South Boston Hall Road. This was new business on February 16th, 2017. So as shown on a plan entitled City of Boston Public Works Department Engineering Division Pedestrian Easement Plan, 41-49 West 3rd Street, South Boston, one sheet dated February 10th, 2017.
Good morning. The request for the easement is to meet the geometry needed for the sidewalk along West 3rd Street.
If you can identify your team members
and
describe the project, that might be a little bit useful. Thank you.
One of those days. My name is Mike Clark with Design Consultants, Inc. My client representative is Bill Anderson with ENT LC, and Michael, now I'm having a...
Michael D'Angelo with Michael D'Angelo,
landscape
architecture.
So to reiterate, the project consists of the development of an apartment building, the block between A Street and the South Boston Bypass Road, Athens Street, in West 3rd. So as part of the project, the sidewalk along West 3rd Street from this location to Boston Bypass Road, a foot of it falls on the property. So we're here to request granting an easement from ENT to the city to allow that this public sidewalk be done.
With the easement, Amy, how wide is the sidewalk going to be?
It's a 1 foot easement.
Gives us a total sidewalk width of then how much?
5 feet.
That's all.
I believe.
Are they going to program anything?
Been to A Street, right?
Plenty more.
That's
sorry.
Palatial.
Are you programmed? Okay. Amy, so you thought through within the 5 foot sidewalk, whatever you program will still leave enough stuff for pedestrians to use that street?
So I think that they actually have 5 feet of cement concrete, and then the trees are planted out.
Yeah, we 5 feet, and then there's a strip that has the trees.
My apologies.
Yeah.
I apologize for not being clear.
From curb to building face?
Curb to building face is the exact distance.
Roughly
a little over 10 feet.
Thank you, sir.
And there's some green strip on the front of the building face, too. Addition to that.
other questions or comments?
Thank you, sir.
I'll entertain the motion.
I'll make a motion to approve the petition by E&T LLC for the acceptance of a pedestrian easement adjacent to West 3rd Street, South Boston, as read into the record by the chair, as shown on the plan entitled City of Boston Public Works Department, Engineering Division, Pedestrian Easement Plan 2149, West 3rd Street, South Boston, one sheet dated February 10, 2017.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
So moved. Next item is on a petition by E&T LLC for the making of specific repairs within the following public ways in South Boston, consisting of new, reconstructed, and relocated curbs, sidewalks, pedestrian ramps, specialty pavements, street trees, and driveway curb cuts. This was new business on February 16, 2017. The locations are West 3rd Street on the southwesterly side, generally between A Street and the South Boston Hall Road. On A Street on its southeasterly side, generally between West 3rd Street and Athens Street. Athens Street on its northeasterly side, generally between A Street and the South Boston Hall Road. This is as shown on a set of plans entitled City of Boston Public Works Department, Engineering Division, Specific Repair, 45 West 3rd Street, A Street, Athens Street, South Boston, three sheets dated March 2nd, 2017.
Again, for the record, my name is Mike Clark with Design Consultants representing E&T. We have Mr. Anderson with us and Michael D'Angelo, the landscape architect. In general, the project consists of development of an apartment, condominium complex in the block between A Street and South Boston Bypass and Athens Street and West 3rd Street. On West 3rd Street, we're constructing pedestrian access with sidewalk, some parklets in the corner, street trees, one curb cut that this location to allow access for parking on the site. We're abandoning a curb cut in this location. On these two corners are existing buildings that are not part of the project, but we are reconstructing the sidewalk through this whole corner here and then down to this location here.
And around the corner?
And just right now, approximately 5 feet around the corner. The one of the unusual circumstance that we're asking is across Athens Street, there's the new developments coming in at 69 and 71 Athens Street. We're located here
on the opposite side, Mike.
On the opposite side of Athens Street and 99 Athens Street. They intend to come into the PIC within the next couple of months. What we're requesting is they've committed in their Article 80 hearings to do a full-width shared street in that location. So what we're proposing to do there is to abandon the sidewalk along this location. It doesn't conform now with ADA requirements. I believe it's about 3 feet wide. That'll be paved and sloped towards the existing gutter line here to maintain the drainage. And Westwood Properties, which is this property across the street, will come in and handle the rest of the engineering and construction on that location. So,
do we know about that?
No. So, no. Mike, it creates a little bit of awkwardness.
Yep.
Because that whole block is yours.
Correct.
And let me assume that the second entity you speak of goes belly. I mean, I don't know them. I'm sure they're very nice people, but they have some other thoughts and go somewhere else. So today, this commission is hearing this project, and I think you need to do what is needed on your side of the street for your project. If you want to reach a separate offline cost-sharing issue with the folks on the other side, that is up to you. But I don't think you can ask this commission to negate what you should be doing on your side of the street. Did I make myself more confusing or?
So, I mean, the alternative is to replace the existing sidewalk there and curb.
Yes. Okay, and it cannot be just asphalt. It needs to be a proper sidewalk.
Concrete
sidewalk. And if you are of the opinion that the nice people on the opposite side
are also tagged with building the street. We, the PIC, shouldn't be caught in the middle. You can reach an understanding with them where they can share in your costs. You should do it, and then you can get a rebate from them. I'm using these words very lightly.
No, I exactly understand where you're coming from.
Okay.
So,
if I could add a little bit to this discussion, they have an approved plan for their project, which is going to be office space, and they are going to provide some parking, which will be accessed down Athens Street and needs to have a two-way street there, which is not the current case at Athens Street with the sidewalks that are inadequate on both sides of the street. So Westbrook Properties has proposed and committed to, in their public hearings, basically plating Athens Street and making it level without sidewalks on either side, but de facto walking spaces.
That doesn't come from the transportation department, the engineering division. I know nothing of that. I don't know about making it two-way. I have no idea where that came from. So it hasn't been approved by the transportation department.
Nor the owner of the street, which would be the public works department. So we respect what you are saying. I'm not trying to say those conversations haven't taken place, but it would be really, really awkward for someone to make those commitments on an asset that doesn't belong to you. So
can I ask a question? Obviously we want to try to facilitate this. In the event that this project is ongoing for a while, so in the event that we, as part of this application, committed to replacing the sidewalk and then the curb, and then in the meantime, as Westbrook Properties came in and did their permitting with you, does that seem like, or it seems like a reasonable approach to me? We're not, this work wouldn't be done until the building was completed. So,
if they get their side approved before you guys are done construction, you don't have to install this as approved.
Right.
They'll install what they're doing. Right. But if you're finishing, then we need a sidewalk over there, and they can come rip it out.
No, and I totally agree to that. I want to make sure that the and if they don't go forward, it would make sense to do that work. So
you need to look after your client, Mike. You need to look after yours. Mr. Clark will look after your interest without compromising the city's interests. Okay.
Is that reasonable for you, Bill?
Yeah.
In the meantime, is this curb remaining? Are you going to take this out?
Well, we are proposing to take the curb out.
And how's the street going to drain without a curb?
We were proposing to slope away at 2% to the existing gutter line.
I've seen no plans of that. I asked for those plans. I asked for that information, I wasn't given it.
Okay. I know they went out to you. I'm not sure what happened.
No, I was given a plan. I asked about catch basin signs. I got that back. I asked about the drainage. I was given some verbiage. I was given no plans to review. I don't understand how you drain a street now, how you're changing the grade and how you're going to do it. I understand you can do it. You can certainly regrade the street to bring all the drainage to where it's supposed to drain now, but I've seen no plans for how that's going to work.
I'm
not going to do it here.
Yeah.
Right, we'll leave revised plans that show you replacing that sidewalk in kind.
So we want to replace it. The question is replace it in kind?
What's that?
Not in kind, immediately.
It's cement concrete.
Cement concrete.
Yes.
Okay.
Right.
It's existing concrete, but the width is short.
Right, yes.
So
as it is all
the
down
out.
Yes.
Okay.
You should be putting back what is there.
Any other plans reflective of what's
no.
being discussed? So does this need to be continued?
Well, I think that if we have plans that show Athens Street going back the way that it is, we can capture that on Mylar.
Okay, so that needs to be a subject.
Right.
So
right.
I guess a question would be the license agreement going forward. We would commit at this time to maintain that sidewalk when and if Westbrook across the street came in and they did their work. Would we need to come in and revise our license agreement?
If you're not putting any, if all you're doing is replacing Athens Street with a standard cement concrete sidewalk, we don't need to include that in the agreement, and it can solely be in the agreement when this becomes something specialty or belonging to your neighbor across the street.
Okay. I mean, that seems like a reasonable approach from our side.
Any further comments or questions?
I'll entertain a motion subject to the provision of the adjustment on Athens Street that we discussed.
I'll make a motion to approve the petition by E&T LLC for making specific repairs within public ways in South Boston on West 3rd Street, A Street, and Athens Street, described and rendered the record by the chair, with the understanding that the existing sidewalk will be replaced with a concrete sidewalk and new curbing, unless the abutting developer comes in first and they can agree on something else. Also, that the curb will remain.
And just the curb will remain, has been removed.
So that the street will drain correctly.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
So moved.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
First item of new business, 55-57 and 65 Seaport Boulevard. Farnsworth Street, South Boston, it's pedestrian easement, sidewalk cafe licenses, projection license, on a set of joint petitions by Seaport Square Development Company, LLC, WS, Block J, LLC, H3 Partners, LLC, the Massachusetts Bay Transportation Authority, and the Boston Redevelopment Authority.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman, members of the Commission. I'm Peter Kohansky from Goulston and Storrs. I'm here on behalf of this collection of parties that are involved in turning this small parcel adjacent to Seaport Boulevard into a pedestrian plaza that will provide pedestrian access from Farnsworth Street to Seaport Boulevard in the Seaport District. The joint petitions are brought by Seaport Square Development Company, which is the master developer of the Seaport Square project, as well as the owners of the two adjacent blocks, Block H3 of Seaport Square and Block J, which abut parcel FT4, which is the subject of most of these petitions in the middle. I'm also joined by Laura Kaplan, who's here on behalf of the MBTA, which is the current owner of this parcel FT4. And Janet Carlson is here from the BPDA. BPDA will be the future owner of the parcel. They're going to take title to it before the public hearing.
Give me a second.
Yeah.
You're going to own the whole blessed thing?
We're going to own all of FT4.
We'll show you. So outlined here, that's all of that is FT4. Okay. Well, John, if you even grab the bigger piece. Yeah. Only part of it is going to be laid out as a pedestrian.
So again, at the highest level, within that space, what is being programmed for this hearing? So you will clarify which areas of whatever the commission votes is going to go revert back to the BPDA. What activities, John?
Oh.
Okay. So when we go through individual petitions, you can say WS, BPDA.
Yes. We'll tell you the pieces of it. Okay, so just to orient you, Seaport Boulevard is there. Block H3 is the home of a newly constructed office building that Boston Global Investors built and occupied. That will have retail uses. It'll have a Capital One bank and cafe use. And then the other side, Block J, it will be the home of the Yotel Hotel, which is nearing construction completion and expects to open in the next several months. Before the construction of these parcels on either side, there was a grade change. All of that strip, the H block and parcel FT4 and Block J, were a surface parking lot. There was a grade change between Farnsworth Street, the end of Farnsworth Street in the Fort Point, and Seaport Boulevard. There was about a 3-foot grade change and a fence. No accessibility along that route from the businesses and residences in Fort Point up to Seaport Boulevard. Seaport Square Development Company, as part of its public realm improvement commitments, committed to reconfigure that, reconstruct it as a pedestrian plaza, which will be a pedestrian link now from the new Seaport neighborhood to Fort Point. The MBTA is the current owner of the parcel, as I mentioned, intends to convey it to the BRA, which is going to help facilitate the construction of this publicly accessible space and ensure that it's maintained by the Association of Unit Owners for Seaport Square, like the other open spaces within Seaport Square. So the first petition brought jointly by the MBTA, the BRA, and Seaport Square Development Company, the master developer, is to lay out a pedestrian easement over the crosshatched portion of parcel FT4. The vehicular piece, which is the rectangle between where it's labeled Farnsworth Street and the pedestrian easement area, is already has the benefit from the MBTA of a vehicular and pedestrian easement. So it is just that piece that would be a pedestrian easement.
The three-foot grade drop which you mentioned.
Yeah.
John, can you show where that area is and how it is mitigated so that pedestrians can actually
So do that? In addition to this pedestrian easement, we're also here to ask for two public cafes, two cafe licenses, and signage. Drawing here for 65 Seaport Boulevard, we propose a sidewalk cafe. So what we have here is at street grade, essentially this triangle here will be at grade, and then there'll be steps that bring it down to the Farnsworth grade. On this side, this upper portion will be grade, again, and then there'll be steps down to Farnsworth. And then we have an accessible path of travel starting here that goes down for wheelchairs and that sort of thing.
Have you applied on that accessible path? Has it been certified by that Architectural Access Board or ADA?
This is a compliant design, and we have reviewed it with the Disabilities Commission, and they're on board. If you'd like to get into the sidewalk cafe, this being the hotel parcel, we are proposing a 16-seat cafe, seasonal cafe here, where we still provide public access around the outside of the cafe. And this will be part of the hotel operation, so the intent is that alcohol and food will be served from the hotel.
John, that accessible path of tavern, when the dust settles, it'll be Janet's, sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. But who is going to actually clean it, plow it? Who is maintaining it?
Seaport Square Development Company, the master developer, will have the obligation to maintain the public, the entire space. The operator will certainly do cleanup, and you know when the cafe is in is in use.
Yes.
Certainly, yes. Certainly not as between us.
So we call you, and then you get called the
right. Exactly.
In the other side of the accessible ramp, we are proposing a cafe here that does not abut the facility itself, but it's going to be run by Capital One, and it'll be a cafe open to public, regardless if you are using Capital One or not, similar to what we've done in other areas in the city. So no alcohol will be served here. There will be, within the cafe itself, they will sell pizza and soda that they can sit down and entertain themselves with. But you do not need to purchase anything from the cafe to use those seats. And there are 12 seats proposed in this area as well.
Lighting for that pathway?
That's a good question. It is lit. I don't have the information, but
so
I will be able
sure
to speak to
it
in public here.
Ensure that there's either adequate lighting at street level, or if the two buildings can have overhead strung lights, make it something that is nice.
Yeah.
Unusual, because we are trying to create excitement here. And this is a unique location where the spot belongs to BBDA. You are responsible, so let's do something where.
Yeah, and I've mentioned it to the commission before. The new owner, Seaport Square Development Company, an affiliate of WS, is in the retail business. That's where they come from. An active, vibrant streetscape is really what they're focused on. So we're lined up with you on that.
And our fourth ask is, if we're here, let's just ask for the signage as well. So part of the hotel project, which is parcel J here, the lighting install, hotel signs, one along Seaport Boulevard and one along this pedestrian easement. The sign is 10, 20 feet above grade, projects out about 6 inches.
It's on the building?
It's going to be mounted to the building. So it's a building mounted sign here that's actually on this section two, that's 10, 20 feet above grade.
Is John, is it flush with the building or protruding into the?
It projects 6 inches into the public way, about a foot from the building.
Has someone much smarter? Has the appropriate city agencies within the ninth floor look at that signage and whether the signage fits into the character of Seaport Boulevard?
I believe it is. It's part of the BBDA
approval. Either to, within the next 7 days, we are going to be looking at how Seaport Boulevard functions,
absolutely,
and hopefully the signage.
I'll verify, but I'm pretty sure that this has been stamped for a sign review.
Yes.
Is the easement agreement been executed for the utilities and the?
It hasn't been signed yet. We have signed. We have an agreed upon form with Jim Steinkraus. I think he signed off. We can have it. We will certainly have it executed before the public hearing.
So now that this is going to be a pedestrian footway, you know, basically a direct connection to Seaport Boulevard, we've got a neck down showing a rather wide handicap ramp. Is there a crossing there?
All those nice people that are going to enjoy that space and they want to say, gee, let me see some water, and they may want to cross Seaport Boulevard. So are they going to swim, fly, crawl?
I believe that is a crosswalk that was been previously approved by this commission.
I think that when it was approved, we were looking, because of the pedestrian generator, of getting the traffic signal included for that. Because of exactly this, is the pedestrian focusing that point on Seaport Boulevard into the park on the other side. So I don't know where that stands right now. Will you get an update on that?
Yes.
We'll give you an update on it.
There are
I don't want to open a big pedestrian generator and have an unsignalized crossing. That would be a disaster.
And sir, if it is needed, your thoughts on morning. All common sense, at least in my little brain, says that one needs a controlled crossing, so we don't have just people after having a little bit of excitement wander into the roadway. So assuming it is needed, what are your thoughts about managing that situation?
Well, I'm not sure I can speak to it. I think I'd like to circle back and see what they've designed.
It definitely was discussed. I mean, I think Howard Stein Hudson was looking at it.
Amy, you may want to introduce yourself.
Yeah.
It's fine.
So. Amy, WSW, the Midwalk Crossing and the Fort Hood Department.
Yep.
Yeah, that's part of the 75% set that the Fort needs to be right now under review. So we have all intents to install it. I think we're just waiting for the summer.
So someone in the appropriate capacity has to testify at the public hearing
That
it will be done, because otherwise we will have difficulty saying all yes to this stuff.
Has there been any community process within the neighborhood, Farnsworth Street, that area, relative to this?
Yeah, I mean, this pedestrian plaza goes back to the approval of the PDA plan, around which there was a lot of process. Both of these blocks have been to the Four Point Landmark District, so there has been.
Any other questions or comments? Do you accept that?
I hope so. Thank you.
Great. Thank
all right.
Final item of new business, Van Pier Boulevard, Marina Park Drive, South Boston, a widening and relocation and abandonment on a set of joint petitions by Van Pier Development LLC, 50 Liberty LLC, 10 Van Pier Boulevard LLC, and 22 Liberty Trust.
Good morning, John Smith with Niche Engineering, and with me is Richard Martini from the Fallon Company. This is really a housekeeping exercise. We were before you in 2015, where we had the private ways reviewed and approved and permitted from the city, from the Public Improvement Commission. Throughout the course of design and construction, the building actually shifted 3.5 feet towards the east.
which put the building within the layout of Marina Park Drive. So in order to do housekeeping and make sure the building is actually within the parcel, we are reconfiguring the parcel lines and reconfiguring the layout of the private ways. So along Marina Park Drive, we are seeking to discontinue about 652 square feet. It's 187 feet by 3.5 feet. It falls right along this area here. And there's a detail here blowing that up. It doesn't change the roadway design at all. The curb lines stay the same. What does happen is that this plaza, which was originally 22 feet wide, is now 18.5 feet wide.
Again, all these actions are associated with a piece of roadway that is considered a private way.
It is a private way with public access.
And it will continue to be a private way, with the petitioner recognizing that the petitioner will not be asking the city to, in the future, make that thing public.
Correct.
Awesome.
So just on, also on the follow up on that, just on our last, you know, go around on this, on these streets, again, it was brought up, we need to get the street name signs as private ways.
Yes.
Because of your meters that are on the street, they think that we're towing off meters.
And that is part of the approved drawings and still is indicated on these drawings, that they need private street signs.
No, but to your point, which I know exactly what you mean, who's the person that can give us the right legal wording? I just need to get the right words on the sign. We'll change them all immediately.
You mean on the street?
On the street sign itself.
Yes, it's just a street name with private way, but I can get you detail on
that. Perfect.
John, you talked about the impact on the Marina Park Drive side. Can you talk about the impact on the fence?
So we're asking for an abandonment along Marina Park Drive, and in doing so, we're asking for a widening of the location on Panther Boulevard to ensure that the parcel area stays the same and still comply with zoning. So here we are widening the private way about 3.5 to 4 feet, the same area, 652 square feet, and the sidewalk here was originally 15 feet wide, and now it's going to.
Any other questions or comments? Okay. Your topic. All right. Well, 2 weeks will be enough time for you guys.
Yes, sir.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you.
That is it. Let's go adjourn.
So move.
Reached out to you yet? But I saw a picture of the TV floating around about replacing the ICAs.